10 car meters off the rear boundary, which has private car parking adjacent to that boundary. So the distance, I think, at this point to that point is 10 meters, and from here to there is 12. Across the back of the site, there's private car parking in relation to flats on, I think it's Dayton Close. The rear flats would also be sited 21 meters from the rear elevation of the front dwelling, and as such, separation distances would be achieved. It is proposed that the new dwellings would be dual bungalows and set out in the description of the development for which permission is being sought. It is considered that the plot can comfortably accommodate three dwellings without compromising the character of the area or the amenities of neighbouring properties. The application is recommended for approval. There is no petition for connection.
Thank you, Matthew.
And
we don't have a
board
councillor here for this application either, so can I
thank you, Chair. Can I just confirm where the road's going to be through there, Matthew? Is it going on the level? Let's go to that. Just a plan on the
Joe?
Just concerned about the size of the small and other bungalows, but how many bedrooms will they have?
As I said, at this point, those details of further approval. We're only approving access and layout at this point, so the actual size of the
I find myself in the weird situation on a number of times with regards to applications like this, not just in terms of anything, but where I have utter sympathy with residents and their issues, and even I concern regarding development and density, certainly compared to the plots in the area. Yeah, I can't think of a way where any of the misgivings would actually constitute sufficient valid reason to refuse this application. With regard to density, the surrounding similar properties, clearly three and a half plots can be considerably more dense. The flats just over the way, I realise that increases the density locally, but I know this area very well. Those flats are like a self-contained kind of site for elderly residents. This part is quite different and there's no access, as you mentioned, it's a wall there, there's a private car parking area. Also, and this is actually a question, not just a statement, with regards to car parking, something else I know isn't really taken into consideration. Is there going to be any space within, or is that going to be taken up when we come to the full application?
As I said, at this stage we're only approving layout and access. So the details of car parking, whether it's integral garages or on-site off-street parking, that's a matter that would be considered at reserved matter stage.
In which case, I suppose I shouldn't really bother saying my next sentence, but I'm going to say Barker Road is pretty narrow, and if you're going to put three cars on that junction, it's probably going to make that junction pretty difficult to navigate, but I suppose that's a hard enough for the second one.
I think that obviously there's an existing property on the plot, so it's a, in pure traffic terms, it's an additional two properties. I think access is one of the matters that's considered under this application. It's not one of the reserved matters. So the access will be fixed by this application that must be approved tonight. I've looked at this location. I'm satisfied that the visibility is okay there. And for the additional two properties, the driveway that they're showing will be sufficient to cater for those two properties.
Okay, thank you.
Stuart? In terms of outline, is the writing of outline plan permission
committee would be approving tonight is the access arrangements and the layout, the rough layout of the site. So how these dwellings would be set out or how they would eventually appear is still for discussion. But I think the initial discussions that we've had is that this part of the office, sort of front dwellings, as it were, would be an integral garage. So as you come into the driveway and drive up it, this part of the site would be a driveway. But I guess what I'm trying to say is there are design solutions that could be employed that essentially would reduce any impact from headlights as cars turn into the private driveway and move off. That could be employed. But we're not at this stage yet. That's part of the reserve matter stage. But at this point, it would be three cars. And originally, it was for four, there were three at the top and one at the front. And so we did negotiate a reduction in units, and we think that this is a scheme that will work out in regards to the size of the box.
Okay, I think the other thing as well is that it's quite a large box, and there's still for some units going on. But I think it's really important that you raise that as a concern, because the officers can take that away and then call the notification. Okay, anybody else? Treena?
Yeah, I'm just mindful again that this is another application that people bring in their building in their back gardens to increase their property value without any regard to the neighbours. It's a shame that nobody's here tonight to put in that objection. But these aren't granted for you, so I know that. But I just want to note that it's another one given to the committee.
Thanks, Treena. Okay, any more comments? Okay, do we have a mover for this? Do we have a mover for this? Thank you, David. Can I have a second one, Denise? Thank you. All those in favour, subject to the conditions listed.
Slopes down sharply towards Grove Road to north. Therefore, properties fronting onto Grove Road sit below the application site. The raised decking and steps would result in some overlooking to the rear elevations of 114 and 116 Grove Road. That's these two properties here. Due to the difference in land levels. Although there is some existing boundary treatment in place, however, to protect the privacy of the building occupies a 1.7 metres high privacy screen. The presence of the screen would not reduce light into habitable rooms and neighbouring properties due to the distance achieved, but it will prevent overlooking from decking and mitigate against loss of privacy. With the privacy screen, the decking is considered to be acceptable and is recommended for approval. There is no petition in connection to this application.
Have we done a couple more councillors here for this committee, please? Denise?
Thank you, Chair. I think due to the topography of the land, it has already been overlooked from wherever, each way from the house on the left and
Chester Road separates the two sites. The proposed development would be a mix of detached and semi-detached properties. The majority of properties are two-storey, though 14 of the units will make use of a deeper roof space, resulting in a half-storey. All will be constructed from traditional brick and tile, reflecting other properties in the locality. This development forms phase three of a wider master plan redevelopment of the area, with phase one and phase two to the east of the site having been completed. Affordable housing provision across the wider development plan area has already been provided for the overall development in phases one and two. The development proposed in phase three seeks to rebalance the housing market, and as such, affordable housing is not provided within phase three, given the overall provision already secured in earlier phases. Off-street parking is provided either in front of or to the side of the proposed dwellings. The site is also well served by public transport, bus routes, and close proximity to Birkenhead North Station. The site is also immediately adjacent to an existing area of public open space and an equipped children's play area. As such, no on-site open space provision is required, and the regeneration benefits of redeveloping these sites and improving the environment of the area is a positive move. A number of detailed conditions deal with drainage and highway works. An additional condition is required to the development in terms of the acoustic noise assessment submitted and measures contained within them within that assessment to minimise and mitigate noise pollution for future residents. So we're proposing an additional condition. Condition 20 would read, the noise mitigation measures detailed in section 5 of the submitted noise impact report by efforts acoustics shall be implemented in full before the dwellings to which they relate offers occupy. Any such mitigation measures shall be retained as such thereafter. The site has had housing on it in the past, and given the development forms phase 3 and an overall development master plan for the area, it is considered that the proposals are acceptable and are recommended for approval. There is no petition in connection with this point.
Can I just ask for clarification, Matthew?
Saying is that he's provided more
as part of the overall plan for a particular area. And in sort of basic terms, the development of phase one then funds the development of phase two, and then the funding of phase three comes from the sale of the properties on phase two. So the overall principles are set out as part of the master planning process, but the applications come through as individual phases.
Thank you, Matthew. Denise, just a quick one, Chair. I just wondered how many houses was phase one, two, and three, how many properties is there, and how many are not going to be there above the
Matthew doesn't know off the top of his head, but we do have to Happy, I was a little bit ahead of myself when you coming back, but agenda item 16 done. Councillor Dowsey has actually handed that business over to his son to deal with. Okay, I'd also like to congratulate our officers following the annual planning survey. The Rural Council was announced to the Council that turns major planning applications around the quickest in the country, so I think congratulations on a very round of applause.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chair.